Hello Gundam fans, this is Brad92, and today I'll be looking at the SD Gundam World Taishi Duel Gundam, and I got the model kit from Canadian Gundam. Link is in the description below. So I think this is the first, and it does have a few elements of the Duel Assault Shell. Like the bulkier shoulders here, you got the skirts on the front and the back. You got the leg armor there, which is a little hard to see because it is clear. And the forehead piece. And a little bit of the chest. So it is there. It's just really, really ornamental, so it's hard to see it all. Now, sticker-wise, you got the eyes. The gold on both shoulders. The light blue on the front of the chest and on the skirts. And then the little white in the middle. And that's it for stickers. They really went crazy with the clear, and they put them in places they really haven't done before. The V-fin is the clear orange, which is fine. And then they put one on the one shoulder. And the side skirts is also clear. And then with the clear blue is the whole top of the head and the chin, both shoulder armors, and then you have the legs, which is also the side piece, the front piece and the side, and the feet. Having the feet all clear blue is definitely different, and then you have it fed through the front skirt. So a lot of clear on this kit, which it should be okay. I don't think it'll be too much of a problem where it's positioned, because, well, maybe the ball joints, because they're clear, that could be a problem in the future. I don't think the feet will be a big deal. Anyways, articulation-wise, you got the ball jointed head with the hinged neck, pretty free there. Arms can go forward and back. They're ball jointed arm, ball jointed wrist, double hinged torso, pretty free. You got the ball jointed waist, ball jointed front skirt, ball jointed side skirts. And you have the ball-jointed hip, hinged knee, and the ball-jointed feet. So pretty standard, nothing really gets in the way of the articulation, because he's not really bulky with the armor, just very detailed. Now weapon-wise, you got this double-barreled cannon, which you have the Gatling memory, which you can just plug into one of four ports. And you just take one of these holes here and you just peg it into the right side of the shoulder. Now, once you push it in all the way, it locks into place. There's a little tab at the bottom of the peg. So you can't move the cannon unless you move the arm. So it kind of resembles the Duel Assault Shroud's shoulder-mounted cannon, kind of. Now for melee, you have a pair of clubs. I guess they figured since the Duel has beam sabers, the clubs will work, I guess. But the cool thing is you can take these and you can plug them into these holes in the cannon, and now you have a quad barrel cannon, which actually matches the symbol on the Gatling memory. But that's not it. If you decide to pick up the blue frame, you can make the fourth mode of the tactical arms. You just have to fold up the blades. And then you just tab these on to the side. Alright, like that. And so now you have the double barrel or the quad barrel, the Gatling gun that the actual blue frame had. And then I guess you just have to take the handle piece and then just how would you do that? You just shove them there. Yeah. And then you can just get the I guess we'll let the Duel do it. Right. No, actually no, it makes more sense with the blue frame. Since it is originally the blue frame that has the cannon. I don't know why his hands don't stand on. But you just take that. I mean, you can't do it without the blade pieces. But the thing is you can't do it without the backpack, because there's nowhere for the Duel to hold it in this form. So you do kind of need the blue frame to pull this off. Come on, get on there. And there you go. And that is pretty cool, the fact that you can use the weapons from the duel. But once again, it's a combination that leaves one mobile suit without anything to defend himself, which I've never been a big fan of. So you could always take, you know, two of the barrels, and then the duel would at least have the clubs, so you could at least beat the crap out of somebody. But, of course, the quad barrel is what the blue frame originally had, so that does make sense. But anyways, that is the blue duel from the Sengoku line. It's pretty cool. I like the way it looks. A lot of clear pieces. I am worried about a few parts that are clear in the joint area in the future. It might be okay. It looks good. The weapons are cool. The fact that you can combine the clubs into the cannon and then give it to the blue frame is also pretty cool. And yeah, it's just so nice to have the duel. Hopefully we'll get the other ones, like the Aegis, the Buster, the Blitz. I think we already have the Strike Rouge, so maybe I think the Strike is coming out, I think. But anyways, if you want to pick it up, click the link below to go to Canadian Gundam, and I'll see you in the next review.